Hi and welcome to Unit 6. This unit has two videos from me, this first one which is introducing the unit and the second one which is embedded as part of the learning activities. So the video that's embedded is about 6 minutes and this one I imagine will be very similar. I just wanted to give you some quick feedback on your quizzes that you did. I have written feedback for everybody in the quiz site. And I just wanted to comment on a couple of things to do with the theories because that's so relevant to what you're working on right now. The quizzes showed that there were some gaps around some of the fine points of the various theories. So you can take a look at where the errors were that you made, if you made errors on the quizzes, and reread those sections. That will help you, especially if those are theories that you're going to be using in writing your papers or your framework down the road. The second thing that I noticed was there was a split between use of cognitive behavioral therapies and person-centered therapies and theories within the analysis that you did in the final question. And I gave you fairly specific feedback around what was right and what tracks you were on. But I just wanted to let you know about the CBT piece. What I was thinking of as I was looking at it was that if I met someone and I listened to what they said was most important to them, then I would feel responsible for assisting them to address the urgency of what was going on. So you'll see immediacy and urgency in my comments. Those of you that chose person-centered, I spent a bit of time thinking about how I could relate that. And so the person-centered theory is really relevant in terms of our engagement. And so in this week's unit, you're going to be talking about engagement. And so we all start with the person that we're with because the relationship starts at that micro level. We all start with that one person and connecting to them. And if we don't connect to them, if we jump right in and start and tell them what to do, we're going to meet with resistance. We're not going to get those items that are critical, that are written up in Unit 6, the trust, hope, sense of worth and competence. Those will not happen in that engagement process or that relationship building that we're doing. So yes, absolutely, you have to come from a perspective that everything you do is person-centered, especially when someone comes to you for help around a situation that they want to change in their life. But the question was framed around working with Nick's anxiety, Nick's fear, and his struggles with his disability. In the context, so looking at the context of university, and each and every one of you really understands what it's like in the first semester of university, you are really at, I'd say, loose ends, trying to figure out how you're going to make this work. And someone who also has significant anxiety and fear of failure, and perhaps maybe a little bit too much dependence on the family for support, can really struggle in the first semester of university. Now, what Nick wants, in my opinion, is to be successful. Nick wants to be able to do well in his courses and be happy in the learning environment. Nick has been successful, and many of you have pointed out that you would look at strengths and you would point out how Nick has done it before, what were the things that he did, and could he replicate them again. That's cognitive behavioral therapy. So we're in a therapeutic relationship here. Nick is not coming to you for a conversation. He really wants something from this relationship. And so your job in this particular assignment was to say, what's the priority? How am I going to deal with the priority? And the priority for Nick, I think, has a 12-week window, which is the length of the semester. And so for him, it's not going to be focusing on looking back over his childhood and spending a lot of time in almost a psychodynamic place of reviewing and onion peeling slowly. Nick's going to want some fast wins. And so you need to ask him where he wants to start. And if getting his anxiety in to some kind of a perspective, if that's not something that he already has found help for, then he's probably going to need to make a doctor's appointment or a clinic appointment and speak to someone about a short-term intervention that can stabilize his anxiety, and that may be medication. Now, medication may be just that bridge that allows you to do the talk therapy and the cognitive behavioral work to help Nick reprogram some of his thinking, his faulty thinking. So you've got the faulty engine theory there. And you will want to help him build a new social story, because he doesn't have a social story for university, but he did have one for his previous in education. So you're going to help him build one so that when he runs into a difficult situation, he's going to have in his mind several things that he can do to get through that. When I don't understand the question, I'm going to go talk to my instructor after class. When this happens, then this. And so your cognitive rethinking the processes, behavioral, what will I do when this happens, and also that biopsychosocial, and some of you hit on the biopsychosocial as being really critical, and I agree with that. But for the overarching choice, my choice and my recommendation would be CBT would be what you would focus on in terms of what has been identified in the scenario. So some of you went and expanded and talked about a number of other theories which are most appropriate. And you also looked at the micro, then you moved to the macro. So perhaps there's study groups, or there are the writing center at the university, or there could be a disability resource center that would allow him to register for accommodations, and that allows him to have some negotiation power with his instructors around what his classroom experience looks like, what his paper writing experience looks like, and what his examination experience can look like. So you could go into those broader categories, and you didn't need to with 500 words, but I want you to keep in mind that when you're looking at a theory, and this is what you're doing right now in your paper, there'll be tons of theories that you could apply. But take a look at the story and say, what is if this person came to me and I asked them, what is the most urgent thing that you want to talk about here today and work on with me? Think what they would say. And you're making an assumption. We all have to start somewhere. And so that's exactly what you need to do when you're thinking about your theoretical approach. I particularly like the idea of looking at social learning theory, because that is a different kind of topic, umbrella, I call it. And it does hold the appropriate tools within it, including CBT, including strengths-based. And so you have these things that you can pull out within social learning that are appropriate when you're working with the individual, when you look at the group settings that are potentially helpful, and you look at the institutional settings. So are there policies of accommodation in this university? Are there study groups that Nick could join? And then are there individual supports, myself and other individual supports, that would be meaningful to him? So when you're writing your paper, keep in mind these points and look back and see what I wrote about your specific information that you put in there, because I think that might help you as you're writing your theory paper. So this week is interesting, and it has a lot about use of self, and the little video that I've put in talks about use of self. So there's also a discussion, a post this week, so you're back to posting and conversations in your group. And I think you'll find it very interesting as you start to talk about use of self. You may or may not be in your practicum right now. I think there's about 8 of you that are not in your practicum. So as you enter into conversations about things that are going on right now, perhaps with your with those group members who are in practicum, you can look back on either the practicum that you've already completed or a work experience that you have been engaged in to draw on what it felt like to do use of self. I think that's it. I hope you're keeping warm. I think most of us are a little chilly and got on the extra socks these days. So I know here it's something about like minus 18. And went out walking this morning and just getting the feeling back in my nose. Anyway, I'm really looking forward to seeing your first papers. Don't hesitate to send me a quick question if you want to know if your theory and the scenario are a good fit, and I'll give you a few pointers. If you have any questions at all, I'll be checking my email regularly. Talk to you soon.